Full Rita gonna have to come into play here for the side of Ascend. Now they're gonna be looking to try and come on the flank and pick off the man of Brave, but already looking to try and spot out those remaining players. We'll probably call for a little bit of support.
Oh, nice shot by CNET. Still with the dash online. He gets out of there, not sectioned in by the Nano Swarm. They've caught Brave as well. Now it's only the players on the site, and they're going to start to feel overwhelmed. Players coming from every single angle. Shock darts in for damage, but they somehow get away. Tension is most likely to get Izzy a kill, get that Bladestorm online, and spread out the funds a little bit more evenly. In fact, he's holding a bit of a solo play down on long, while the rest of the team splits into short.
Already, Poor is going to be dropped. CNED will deal with him as he tries to push through alone. Izzy already managing to find the trade with that rifle. Bladestorm available to him if he desires, and he will pull it out almost instantly, but Killers is there to shut him out. They're making this one costly, that's for sure, but still a 2v3 for the defenders.
Yeah, another player drop, leaving Turco all by himself, but he was described as a clutch player. This time, he won't be finding anything. A round found for Ascend. Two players, obviously having Zeke on that Odin is a big investment in these early rounds. And Izzy takes a headshot, doesn't even use his dash to get out. Massive information for them to play with. He has the Odin to work with as well, so that's going to be sprayed straight away to take down the Killjoy ultimate. The lockdown not in effect, and 20 seconds left. Supermassive Blaze have been completely outplayed. They need to just run into a stacked up site, and Ascend are toying with them, just running the clock down. Left. 10 seconds to get the spike planted. And there's still so many players on the site. That was a fantastic win for that weapon, but it got them the round there. Oh my, but he's going in for it. Killers, an absolute madman, and it works out for one.
Yeah, I think this is one of the things that's always going to be added when you have an Astra. Just the ability to have these dirty little setups pulling players into angles, and especially in a round like this where there's only going to be pistols in play, it's going to become fairly difficult. And seen it. That's probably the most knives I think I've ever seen fired off in one go. But hey, if he's gonna get himself early information, seems to be the aim of the game. Passing of the drones, and Starzo tries to peek off the back of it, but Izzy will win that opener. Further information for Zeke, and he's gonna go for the wall bang. He's gonna get it as well. An instant trade
for the post plant, right? Yeah. There we go.
Spike planted.
Okay, a lot of information garnered from the defensive side, but they're going to wait for that full rotation. They actually have a lockdown here as well, so you almost feel like the attackers are going to have to try and fight for some tree control, otherwise this is going to become incredibly difficult. They don't have any counter to it either. There are a couple of shock darts, but I don't know if they're going to be able to land it from here.
Important to break the wall first, just so that they can't focus entirely on the lockdown. They have to worry about CNET coming in from above, and as the lockdown comes to fruition, Russ is staying in position. He catches them off guard and grabs a kill. That's good work by Russ, thinning out the numbers of the defensive side, but they're still covering this. The spray from the Odin grabs a triple out of Zeke, and that is going to be close, but I think they've just about got it. Oh no,
they don't.
Time's a little bit too low, 0.48 of a second. An aggressive mid control. He is still sitting around here, still with the dash online, so he's going to play that little bit more aggressive and look to catch them as they come on through. Already up close is Izzy, and he catches him off guard. A quick headshot and opt to be retrieved potentially by Supermassive Blaze. More importantly, the man advantage is now theirs.
Trying to bait out a shot or two, but it's actually Starzo that takes the
drop. They have to play aggressive off this over on the Supermassive Blaze side. They know that Hunter's Fury is coming in. They want to seize the map control first. They've managed to go all the way towards the spawn. Holding up close as Killez comes out. Oh, that spray was so good! Huge damage done! These other players, 50 HP, and Zeke isn't even going to be blinded up. They're dropping down. 30 bullets left in the magazine.
Oh, no!
It's more than enough. That's four kills for Zeke on the backside. And Bora all alone with 9 left. They do not want to peek. They just want to run down that clock and then constantly farming up those lockdowns, but they never really do anything for them. The counter's always there on the other side. The mid control that Supermassive Blaze have found again and again works out this time around for the bait, but they still need to deal with Zeke. So far, he's been untouchable, but he's only good for one. Starzo, Rez online, but no ability to get them back up. He has to take the duels as they come on through this choke point, and they just swing wide, taking him down, finding the B site, and Supermassive Blaze may just have found an answer for getting into this site and winning a round.
They do actually manage to catch out Brave, though. I need a peek that maybe is a little bit audacious. Cosmic Divide probably not going to be too valuable in this scenario unless they can try and section off the jewels, maybe close out the boat house, give them something a little bit extra for this spot, but Bone Cold being caught leaves it all on to Killers, and they know exactly where he is. That's two instant shots! It's into the one versus one. The turret may not spot out Poro, at least for the moment, but it gives just that little bit of extra information. I think he thinks he's over into the boathouse, so Poro will close it way too close for comfort. And only, but that's the thing, we've got a lot of ultimates online, but some that will just be used as direct counters to others. So, if anything, for now, Supermassive Blaze is just going to go in. Actually, Zeke's just popped his. This means they could, in theory, use the lockdown at a later date. He's done a lot of damage off the back, and actually Killers has gone down to the Nano Swarm. A little bit of a surprise. We're going to see those ults go out exactly the same time, but one's already going to be destroyed by the Hunter's Fury. However, the frags are going pretty well so far for Ascent.
They're going to bail out, let this lockdown go to completion.
All of
that's
them.
A big problem. All three players
to
take. They're hunting them down. Brave finding two. And it's all down to CNET, who's still trapped. That is a big, big loss for Ascends. They are going to run into another heavy stack, but this time it'll be against Rifles. And Izzy is already on the site. He's being pulled in. He's being challenged. Somehow, though, managing to evade detection, make it to backside. Russ and Turco combined for a double entry. And this is a disaster out of Ascend. A great attempt by CNET up above, but Russ shuts him down on the trade. And Supermassive Blaze are not giving away these advantages.
Oh, finally, we're going to see that res pop. It took the final round of the half for something to be invested here for Ascend as they look to make their way through. It's Brave to shut down another, and they will hold on to the site. 7-5 in favor of Supermassive.
Massive Blaze on the defense, and that's a great shock dart to start it, and a second right on the Bone Cold. No smokes for this push and very little health.
He's done about 200 damage with that one. I'm pretty sure that Jonas is going to have a big smile on his face after that one, but we'll see. It's going to be the push coming through. Russ in a solid position to at least try and get something done. They need to isolate him, and they will, but they've taken so much damage along the way. Still, though, it comes back into a 2-versus-2 scenario. Izzy playing ring around the rosy, and it leaves just one man standing. It's Zeke.
I'll look to peek him together. Or not. Teed at all. There's an immediate tag, a dash out of there. Izzy now on 50 HP, is to be much more cautious about peeking any of these pistols.
I think he was going to try and make a bit of a push back towards Turco. Luckily, I don't think he's going to need that extra HP. Turco just farming up every single player. And, nice shot from Izzy to close it as well. One player drop, not too more stacked up on that side of the map. The kill to a utility. He's holding things back, and CNET is going to find the opener, but at a fairly hefty cost, and Izzy is already going to pick off Zeke.
Into the site now is a pretty big challenge. You know, for Ascend, if they manage to just lock this out, hold down the crossbars with the weapons that they have, it should be next to impossible. And take a look at the utility for Supermassive Blaze. With the exception of a recon, they haven't really got anything to play with. Now recon's about to be thrown out, signaling that the push is about to start. Drop down. Oh, well, the wall bag's taking them down. This is looking a little bit shaky. Ascend losing lots of players. Izzy, the last alive. He found three in that round. Supermassive Blaze, quite a bit away from rotating. These players on the site need to do a massive job of holding it down. It's Pora and Russ caught inside the boathouse. Pora is somehow able to avoid being pulled all the way in. He catches them by surprise. The Bladestorm doesn't connect. And Russ, the final man standing there. Sure, he'll go down, but he's already taken three kills. He's left Starzo all alone. And even with the plans, the res won't be online. And they're rushing him down. Look at that paranoia dash in, and you are gone out of the round. Supermassive Blaze doing such a great job here.
Pace a little bit here. I like this from Supermassive Blaze, though. A three-man stack early. They are going to get scanned up, though. And Izzy, he's going to stick around, but he only just survives. He will get healed back up, at least for the moment. But the rest of the team is starting to be pincered on. It's going to be a spray down, though. They've just destroyed the push of Ascend, leaving just two players remaining. And honestly, at this point, what does Zeke and Killers do here?
Zeke's got the ult orb, at least. That's something that we've talked about. The fact that the fact that you're being split, a lot of trouble, but instead the idea.
The way we're going to see the Hunter's Fury popped, and actually, Russ, while going to try and take out the ult, has actually managed to take two kills with him! We are going to still see the killjoy ult go through, though. He didn't destroy it, he just ended up killing the players.
He got a kill, and then he targeted it. Obviously, seeing where the other Hunter's Fury was coming from, Starzo putting up a good fight on the site. Move towards his teammates now after a quick double kill, but getting out of there is kind of tough getting over towards this side. So instead, he's going to play inside of main and look to take the contact as they cross over and then swing with Killers. This is a powerful setup for Ascend. The smoke on Brave might give them a little bit of an opportunity, swapping over the op. Bogdan's Law there just to allow Brave to try and take this kill. Take advantage of his low HP, and in fact, Izzy's gone in for two! This is ridiculous! He's on the side and going for the defuse. It's gonna be taken halfway. The turret doesn't even catch him to start with, and inside the Cloudburst, he is defusing, dropping down. Izzy takes the kill to Gilles, and that is a disaster of a round! They tend to be pretty good at just brushing these things off. Me, on the other hand, I'd probably be having a meltdown.
All the way over to the B side.
Yeah, they have a lot of ability to delay when it comes to A, but it looks like there's going to be a push straight through it, and Bone Cold, even on just one HP, manages to sneak past through the Poison Orb and find himself the opener. The wraparound from Russ is also going to meet Bone Cold on the Brimstone, and he's going ham in the pistol. Three kills already. Last man standing will fall to Killers and Ascend win a clean pistol round. Eventually clear it out, but the fact is they're now pushing into a three-man stack with only 25 seconds.
Couple little tags in there for Bone Cold. Flash gets him, but he still takes down Izzy. Now looking for a little bit more, but out of ammo, the pistol had to come out. A player spotted on the site, but they don't know about CNET, who swings out and grabs a double, a triple, in fact, leaving Pora all alone, and CNET finishes him.
But he's waiting on the edge of it. A push through here would almost definitely grant him a kill. And is he going to be able to avoid the drone? I think he has. Now that smoke might not last much longer, but he's going to find himself a freebie for certain.
The orbital strike, again, this is just splitting the push. They're stopping them coming out of back. Going to commit for this round. Starzo actually getting pushed on. And with 10 seconds left, this could be an opportunity to get a plant down. What? Another kill comes back. But Brave needs to deal with Zeke if they're to have any chance. And the time was too low, let alone his health is on 0-5. Rotation as well. We're again seeing the adaptation, the on-the-fly thinking coming out of these guys. CNET's going out for more. I don't know if he realized.
Yeah, before joining this squad. And, well, maybe there's a reason Izzy's picking up.
Let's do him like that. They're slowly pushing up long. There is a flank play coming in. Starzo's again taking contact. Teammates are there, and this is textbook. This is clean.
Something at least, and they may not know the Starzo's waiting on the corner. But here strikes Izzy again. It's only one, but there is no chance for Killers here. He should be shut down at the back of the site, and is left onto Bone Cold.
Yeah, the 1v4 that looks practically impossible. Great push out of Supermassive. I much prefer to use it for post plant, you know? Okay, it's there to help you out in hookah, but anyways...
A very aggressive position as well from Zeke. Normally, we'd call this the one and done. Oh, he's going to be in quite a bit of trouble. Screwed. He has to go peeking, and actually, he'll take one out. Oh. Goes back with the showstopper, and he's still staying alive. The name get him out of there, and Zeke is just going ham. A third player dropped. He should have got nothing from that position. And now it's left all onto Pora. Everybody on the side of Ascend is just thrown down in the smoke.
What was he doing?
He had the Tiger out.
It was a choice. No, I think it was a flash, right? And he had a choice of either popping a flash or even if it was the Tiger getting out of there. Just the information wasn't there to play with.
Nice.
That's the spawn. They won't be able to do much up against this Viper's Pit. They have delayed the plant a moment and the nade through. Oh, this is going to buy time. Zeke goes right into the site. An ambitious play that does not pay off.
This has just become spraying through a Viper's Pit, and it's not exactly gone to plan. It's left all up to Starzo, incredibly low. Now the spike was dropped, and they're yet to get it planted, but it will eventually go down. This leaves the possibility of this round as slim for none. He needs an instant frag, and Pora is already
fine. Coming into the rest of this half with two rounds left, but Zeke has just been completely destroyed.
Alright, Pora's starting to wake up a little bit. He's actually going to go through his own screen! That just opens up the A-site solo! The remaining three players from Ascend might actually have a choice to make here. Maybe thinking about keeping some of the weaponry through. Now, we see that! He's just gone down, taking three players with him!
Far away with an operator in hand, the bullet gives him a haircut up behind Brave! Shuts Bone Cold down, and Starzo again needs the clutch. Up against an off, the flash will be shot out, but the time is so low. All he needs to do is run that clock down, and I think Izzy has gotten away with it. Another round for Supermassive Blaze. by this.
Had the right idea, and you can just see him running back and forth. They fall into Zeke, and CNET is quick to keep the advantage in their favor.
Oh, his pathing was a little bit rough there, but luckily no one got around to punish him in time. A recon to backside destroyed instantly. They know there's two players here, but CNET is taking them down through the wall. There is nowhere to hide from this guy right now. Super Massive Blaze choose instead to run away. But they're not going towards the A site. Not just yet. It's a relocation around to long. They don't want to jump out. Oh, well, they don't want to jump out of hookah, but they're going to jump up long, right into his scope. Give a free kill away, and with 10 seconds left, CNET quickly dispatches.
Up at least.
And the pistol, the Sam going to be going in for a faster A play. Zeke getting a lot of distance. Supermassive plays have been pretty sick when it comes to pistol rounds, at least over on Ascent. We'll see if the same awaits them here.
Well, not going to find anything through the wall, at least at this moment. We need to be a little bit hopeful. There are two players coming in on the flank. Killers, if he goes down, there won't be as much afterpawn utility. He's done a lot of damage, though. Another support can actually roll in to try and help him. He might not need it, but the kills come back big and fast. Zeke and Starzo putting it back into a 2v2, and all this time the spike has been ticking. They need to get moving, and on that flank, trying to split them apart, but Starzo is hitting absolutely everything.
And is looking to try and get a closer range fight. His teammates can't really come to help him just yet. So much fight for utility, keeping them locked out. And look at that, Brain down to 2 health, so close to being able to open it up, and in fact, they still do.
Visions I've ever seen, and he immediately turned away, knew that he had to hold this position. So well played, big Brain from Russ, and even though he dies in the end, this is a round that was under heavy threat just a few seconds ago, and now they have to rely on Starzo pulling off a clutch. In fact, he's going aggressive to try and catch them off guard, as he's already taken down. 6 seconds left. That plant will be secured. Turco, the sky on the other side. It's the headshot to close this one out for Supermassive Blaze. A round that probably should have been a little bit more convincing, but if it wasn't for that, they'll look to take across the line. And it starts out so well. Izzy, a player who's really struggled so far, gets shut down right away, and Zeke is looking to take another fight, holding the angle and waiting for a player to come around the corner. Turco obliges. Kill doesn't go to either team. Zeke, though, going back.
Players are still inside hookah waiting to jump on out with the spike in hand. This is a dangerous play, a risky one indeed. And Bonecold, he's not going to catch the kill. Sure, Killaz trades it back, but look at this down on long. Tucked away is Turco, and he catches them off guard. 20 seconds to deal with them, a double TP to close them.
These ultimates to play with. This is a sort of round where you can't really just run.
Oh, that's really unfortunate. That's the more typical position for the Viper's pit to be put down from, but it's much deeper, so the orbital strike doesn't catch anybody. Pora able to play outside of it and then fight right back in. CNET basically on 1 HP. The push outside of hookah did a little bit of damage. Bonecold is through with 3. A res in, but Russ is undetected. They have no idea that he's on the site, but Bonecold again shutting them down. Sure, CNET falls, but it's a 2v1, and Bonecold aces the round.
He's dead 9 times out of 10. Oh, Russ might be as well.
No.
Great utility usage. Izzy, not good for the kill, and Zeke takes him down.
Not
that's
like
enough
this.
Retrieve. Starzo's eliminated. Turco, the B side is theirs. And Ascend have a 5v2 to look to close this one out, to stay alive in this tournament in Masters 3 and bring us all the way to the deciding map.
Can't end it with a thrifty. You just can't end it with a thrifty. It's only left on to Brave, the youngster, to try and give them something in this round. It was a beautiful execute, but this is not the way that SMB wanted to fall out of this map. Very
he's
gonna have to try and run away.
Was that a spray that he's put down that got a few shots out of him?
The rest of the players are looking to try and challenge through the ice wall, breaking it with Russ on the other side. He's going to get a 1-for-1 trade, but that control is worth it.
Tough retake in play. Izzy out there fighting alongside Turco. He gets dropped in the open. CNET is just hitting shot after shot, and Bonecold is an absolute animal when it comes to these pistol rounds. Porrit can't even get out of the smoke.
One home, and for now at least, there's a good chance to overwhelm him. He still has his dash online, so he can take an initial kill. He's actually going to go in for 2, and in fact, he's just decided to continue fighting. Some would say this looked like an eco.
Yeah,
cool. Yeah,
I got some kills.
Have you not watched me play before? do you know who I am?
You imagine how exhausting it would be if he got that excited every time we get a 4K. Here he goes, diving down onto them, but CNED! Yes, but now just pistols are getting the better of them. Stampeding down the ramp, they've been heard, and these players are turning to watch them. Izzy taking first contact, Zeke is in trouble. And I don't even know if they go for this. With a Phantom on Zeke, with a Spectre in Killez's hands, you might just want to save this over. Killez try to get as much damage as he can, because it's unlikely this round goes their way at this point.
Finding that kill from behind might just change their mind, an opportunity to potentially pick them apart, but both, especially with the Phantom, he is spraying, and it's still fine.
Now they've got CNED here to break the wall and almost get a kill out of a great flash up. Russ goes down, but they're returning. They know that Zeke is below, but it doesn't matter. Good for three, knowing exactly where Pora is as well. The nade is primed and ready. There's the swing ball. I mean, as this wall breaks, he'll have to go back, surely, unless Zeke does something absolutely ludicrous. Just like that, out he goes and back he goes, getting healed up on his way. Now they're coming right up towards B, but the showstopper's online, and he goes himself. He's taking himself down. I swear, I saw Pora die in my eyes. It happened, but somehow it was Zeke falling to the floor. That is not quite how you want the showstopper to go. Reminiscent of some of the earlier games in the group stage.
Seems like Sub Rosa made it here after all.
Oh wow. Okay. All right. And he's not awake yet. It's okay. You got another hour to make those jokes. This is going to be a clean round, though, in the end for Ascend. Surely Turco has to clutch it out, but they talked about him as the clutch player! What was that out of Bone Cold? Why was he shrouded stepping onto the side? Turco, 1v3, and now it's only Killez who stands in his way.
Rez.
The spike plant comes into play, and with that, Rez is online, but he can't get over to them to bring anyone back to life. He'll have to handle this one all by himself, but Killez has given away his position, and Turco gets away with all
them down as much as humanly possible. Are they going to be able to do anything? Though Pora, in fact, winning the duel, and Izzy using the showstopper to make sure the site is in their hands. Sure, it's a trade here and there, but ultimately, this is a solid take for SMB.
I have to say, that was terrifying, the doubled up audio of that fire in the hole. Not much to be found here. Sen need to fight their way back in with some big kills. And Zeke's the point, man. There. Brave already down. Cosmic Divide. Zeke sort of bought them the space to jump out of that. And yeah, Starzo's going to do just that. Getting into the corner. CNED with a quick kill. And now, all of a sudden, Ascend seem to be favored. Turco having to clutch out another 1v3. And although he'll get the first
Supermassive Blaze to go back for another rotation.
Yeah, they've realized that if they push through this choke point, they're just going to get paranoid and taken down. Instead, they're going to try to split up through mid, where CNED is holding the blast pack, actually pushes his teammate out of the way. CNED re-peaks and gets dropped by Izzy. Bone Cold, sure, they'll eliminate Pora, but now they're trapped both behind the site. Starzo gone undetected for a moment, but he's in the nade. He's gone, he's dead, out of the round, but it's kept even. 2 versus 2. The spike needs to be planted. It's been retrieved, and it's on its way to site, but the time doesn't even matter. You don't want to run blindly into pistols. And even though Izzy held that angle, that was no paranoia for Bone Cold this time around, so it's going to be a little tougher to hold onto the side as they push on out. The squids revealing that there's plenty of players here. I sort of like this from Supermassive Blaze, though. They slow it down and hope they get peeked into, but unfortunately it's the Vandal that takes the fight. Then it's CNED's Bladestorm from up above that shuts Rust down, and with 10 seconds left, they might even be thinking about a save if Ascend allow them to do that. The Bladestorm still looking to take some victims. Bone Cold shuts one, and Brave is trapped in a corner. The nade is on him. All the weapons removed. And what a fantastic eco from Ascend. The camera spotting them up above. And there's still a heavy stack on this site. They know that Izzy is coming up close. But even despite that, he manages to get a double. The old pop just to buy the space to make sure there's no trade and to ensure that the plant could go in.
See, spike planted. The neural theft giving things away. An opening needed. While Zeke is already going to pick one off, this gives them the chance to potentially get the res, and now he's going to throw out his showstopper, force them back at least for the moment, try and bait someone in, but won't find anything from it. No one yet to be brought back as well, with both players dying within the site. The nade again, going to clear some of those closer angles. Turco holding, Izzy with another, and the boombot takes one down. It's left all onto CNED, and he's... Oh, we're going to see the boombots passing the wind. Info for Bone Cold, but the spam through gives his position away. Starzo will be there, but Yeah. Just holding onto those ropes with one hand. Or maybe in another way.
Cena down right away, and this is the ideal Teed site control, and that's ultimately what they're after. At this point, a retake for Ascend, it's essential that they get this online.
Well, of course, again, it will be the last round of the half, whereas Rez is going to be coming through. Opportunity, at least, for them to bring something back. They catch the wraparound this time as well. And again, we're going to see that Cosmic Divide. The jump through from Zeke looks to clear the back angle, but does he expect a second player to be there? The answer is no. Already within the cage, this could be a bit of a nasty surprise. He's going to go through, and that's CNET down already. He's going to be able to escape. A nasty surprise for Killers as well, as no trade is found onto his teammate. And now they're going to start to pressure onto that A site.
Yeah, the panic nade goes out. Really just worried about getting pressure down. Rotate through, but Zeke is up on top. They suspect it! And Bora is holding as he gets on through the smoke. A couple of players tagged up here. Things start to get a bit scary. I don't want to see Starzo fighting this on 20 HP. But now he's flashed up. Hasn't really got a choice. Kill has no providing the support from afar. And Bora's low. This is starting to get a little bit more competitive than I thought it was going to be. Brave! Again on the flank play, though. Comes up!
They have Russ and Izzy both having rifles. This is an incredibly strong buy with plenty of potential.
Bora has actually spotted Zeke up close, and he goes out for more to allow Russ to trade. This is so well played by Supermassive Blaze. Ascend are in absolute shambles until Starzo and Bone Cold step it up.
Yeah, they've got the wall to at least give them a little bit of space around the site. Though it's a headshot angle for Izzy, and that's not something you want to give over to this man. We're going to see the TP to the back of site. Bone Cold at least able to take a tiny bit of space, but this jewel seems to be everything, and that's almost ignoring the fact that Brave has still got the closer angle around the spawn. He's also got his stars placed to try and stun up the planter, although he isn't going to be able to push off it, at least for the moment. This 2v2 will continue for now as Izzy looks to try and wrap around, not knowing if there's still somebody within the smoke.
That's a great backside smoke. Starzo eliminates Brave. Izzy has to make the play happen, and he won't get anything done. They lined up. I was a little bit
back. Gonna be left with no shields and a shotgun, and Zeke is just blast packing his way through. Brave doesn't even know he's here. Russ still finding the trade, but Zeke again with a double opener. These fast-paced attacks onto the B site are catching Supermassive Blaze off guard, and for now at least, they can't deal with them.
I don't blame them, because it's so difficult to actually create that kind of space on a map like Split, which is so centered around choke points. Zeke's been spotted down below. The nades traded back and forth, but that buys time for the attackers, and the clock is definitely in their favor. Zeke needs to make a move. He's trapped in a corner right now, and instead of him moving out, it's his teammates coming to help. Pora with a quick kill has been spotted up close. Starzo's waiting for him to take a step back. Good kill for one, and Pora!
It's going to be a fast take, giving them that extra elevation, and this double duo on the entry. He's not going to kill off Brave. The trade, though, again, it's just perfect. Zeke finding a double kill. The remaining players having to try and rotate in, and at this stage, they're going to try and use those Seekers to at least find themselves something here, because they need a way back into this round.
They absolutely do, and they've got Bone Cold reloading right onto CNET afterwards. Zeke gets nothing done on backside. Russ is tearing them apart, and now it's all up to Kulez. He has to swing in and find a double kill. The first goes his way. He knows they're not defusing, and now, being pushed on. He'll still connect. Great play by
to either of those players, though. Instead, it's going to be the contact that they look to take. And with Brave falling, this is where Izzy gets close. If he finds a kill, this could spiral out of control so quickly. The Showstopper now online. He doesn't know if there's players just around the corner, though. He has now spotted them. The nade to keep them back. He's going to hold on to this for a little bit later on. Now that they've spotted out a player up close, and he knows there's one in heaven, the Showstopper comes through, and there's only two players left on Ascend. This was another round where Supermassive Blaze came in with pistols, and it could be another that Ascend lose to a Thrifty. Surely not. Bone Cold up in heaven shuts down Poor, and now it's just the two up close, and look. The position of Turco was spotted, but they had no idea about Russell. It actually went for it in the open! Why would he do that?
Only available if the opportunity is there for either side. Is he not going to connect his shot? And actually, we're going to see the blast pack through! That could be a huge upgrade, but Zeke is actually just going to sit in the corner. An afterplant already guaranteed. Rifles being picked up as well. There is a chance that Ascend just break this straight back.
They may well do.
Said it was potentially a mistake, but it looks like they're really recovering on this one. Pora can't get anything done. CNED supporting from afar, and Zeke get in here, and the shots are not connecting. Time is too low. At this point, I'm walking right into a judge is never the way to go. This is the round done. The question is, does Russ get out with the rifle? The answer is no. He's about to be shot in the back.
11-9. That is... I'm going to use the phrase stupid. That was so aggressive. I was like, there is absolutely no way he gets away with anything and then snaps back to get two kills. That's a round that they desperately needed, and he has just won it for them.
Absolutely. Without Pora, and honestly, if he goes back to spawn, their chances of winning go down greatly because they're playing a retake into, like, giving the space for Ascend to set up. It away 100%. The problem is they're isolated on site. Izzy needs to go nuclear. Pora swinging around and catching a good angle. Izzy only good for the one, and the res comes right back in. Ascend looking to close this one out here and now, and they are getting all the kills. Super massive blaze in the dumps. Brave and Turco need a 2-5 to close this one out. They found the first and the second. Maybe we shouldn't count them out just yet. Brave walking forward might catch the timing on Starzo here. No, he's taken down. And so Turco, the clutch player for Supermassive Blaze, is the last.